For the Drills and Skills product review, we reviewed the Pop-Up Defender. Pop-Up Defender sent us these defenders, and my players and I loved them. Much better than a cone, which some players go over or trip over. Better than a chair, where you don't get injured if you get too tight to. These defenders were big in size, really flexible if hit, and were really nice looking on the court. Great material, great quality, also good for storage as well. I'm giving these a big Drills and Skills thumb up. Pop-Up Defender, check them out.
Go through our skate drill. So I'm gonna come through my legs, I'm gonna go hard inverse. So if I go through my legs, right, first defender, second defender, if that defender cuts me off, I want to protect the ball and push back through my legs. I'm now gonna skate 1, 2, 3. When I get here off the third, ball in my right, I'm coming through my legs. I want to attack. Now I'm gonna be in a ball screen split situation. So I'm gonna attack up, in and out, foot above, driving that big out. I'm gonna tap the ball low. 1, 2, into my finish. Okay, so what we really wanna work on, right, is game situations, by being able to get in and out of moves, keeping the tight handle low through the split, and then changing directions quick right here. Let's take a look.
In dedication to International Left-Handers Day, we got to work on that left hand. This is Chris's offhand. We want to drill it and work on it until he's comfortable with it and just as good as his right hand. We work on a different series of dribble moves, working on change of speed, stop and go, and then attacking. As he attacks, he comes off low and then gives that accurate bounce pass to hit his target with his offhand. Watch if he keeps the ball low so he's not telegraphing it.
Anytime I feel you, I'm lifted up. I'm too addicted to your touch. The separation made me stronger. Won't be dependent any longer. I'm getting used to it was rough. But I've been doing better. I've been doing better.
With my players, I always emphasize confidence and going game speed in almost anything that they do, on the court or in life. So here we see our players work on handling the basketball, gaining confidence to handle it in the full court. Then they go for a one-bounce pull-up jump shot, they go for a curl for a catch and shoot, and then a jab and go, making sure they're holding their follow-through till the ball hits the rim. When I teach, I always emphasize footwork. We got to focus on how the footwork's set up and how we can use it to beat a defender. Chris jump stops on the catch, makes a jab as he reverse pivots, then cross step, protecting the basketball. He then makes a quick stop, hesitation, goes quickly between the legs, and as he attacks the help defender, he makes a quick spin, watch where he really covers a lot of ground, protects the ball for an offhand finish. In dedication to International Left-Handers Day, we got to work on that left hand. This is Chris's offhand. We want to drill it and work on it until he's comfortable with it and just as good as his right hand. We work on a different series of dribble moves, working on change of speed, stop and go, and then attacking. As he attacks, he comes off low and then gives that accurate bounce pass to hit his target with his offhand. Watch if he keeps the ball low so he's not telegraphing it.
Anytime I feel you, I'm lifted up. I'm too addicted to your touch. The separation made me stronger. Won't be dependent any longer. Been getting used to it was rough. But I've been doing better. I've been doing better.
Yep. Nope.
Drop speed, okay. Drop speed. Okay. I know. Okay.